Okay, I'm shooting my video now.
Can I
see this? No. Go away, you're gonna make me camera shy. Guys, and welcome back to my channel. Hi, how are you? Firstly, my name is Kyle, and welcome back to the Kyledom. So, I think from the introduction or from the, I don't know these YouTube terms, but from the title of this video, you must be wondering, like, Kyle, we just saw you post the introduction video, what's this? So, the reason for this video is because I kind of feel like my introduction video didn't do any great things for me. Firstly, I felt like I love speaking in public. And I am never scared of no. You know what I'm saying? But I felt like I was really scared in that moment. And I kind of put on this facade as to who I was. Very superficial, very... It wasn't really authentically to what I am. This is not a pop culture channel. Or just something that's going to be facetious and a vocab word. Ding ding, Mario, get that coin. But... I don't want this to be lighthearted. The reason why I even thought of doing a YouTube channel was to tackle things on a real basis. Right now, as a world, in South Africa yesterday, the president had just announced a 2-week additional lockdown to our quarantine.
Coronavirus! Coronavirus! I'm telling you, shit is real! Shit is getting real! Woo!
That in my friend groups and people that I'm friends with, I'm usually the person who makes them laugh. I'm the person who kind of makes them forget about their problems. I'm the person who gives great advice about relationships, even though I'm single, like the last slice of bread in an Albany loaf, you know, that last one, the dry one. That's me, boy. Dry as hell. But I kind of wanted to also let you know like what I really want to do with this channel. So firstly, some major challenges that I have encountered while, you know, in my life that I would like to keep on this channel is stuff like weight and like body dysmorphia. That's where you view yourself worse than you really are. And I know you may be thinking like, Kyle, you look perfect. I mean, you got thighs, you got waist, you got base, God bless you.
Who said that? 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 Who said that?
No, on a serious note, like, my weight has really impacted in my life, you know, with self-confidence issues, in doubting myself. I work in this really lovely hotel here in Durban, in this world, the South Coast, for your international guests. In Durban. I know, I'm just joking. In Margate, in Wellington Michaels. And I've noticed even in my work life, you know, this major self-confidence, it's just true confidence. And not what we see on Instagram and on YouTube, where everyone's fake confidence and everyone has a meltdown every 30 days.
Hi all, James here. I'm currently traveling abroad and just woke up, but I wanted to sit down and make a video addressing everything that's going on right now.
You know, this channel is not about that. This is the place that I want you guys to be able to subscribe to and click on to escape your day-to-day stresses. I honestly was very creatively blocked when doing this, as I didn't know what I wanted to really speak about. Like, I didn't know what I want to do. I'm not really saying I'm not Liza Koshy. I'm Indian, yes, but I am TikTok famous. Into like, voice killing it. I'm just... but... I really want you guys to kind of mold my content. I want to do content around what you think I should put out. So I was actually thinking by first really allowing you to get to know me.
You're perusing, at times confusing, slightly amusing, introducing.
So firstly, my name is Kyle. My full name is Kyle Duncan Naidu. I decided for my stage name or something just to go by Kyle Duncan. It sounds very cool. I like it a lot. I hated Duncan growing up. I am 21 years old. I will be turning 22 on April 28th, so I'm going to be 22 years old. Uh-oh, I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Everything will be alright if you keep me next to you. I enjoy speaking, I enjoy laughing, I enjoy just having a great time. If you know me, and if you are getting to know me, you'll get to know that very off the bat. Sorry, I look really crusty, I didn't really wash my face. I went out for the first time today, so I chose not to wash myself. I know that's dangerous and against health violations, but I want to embrace the moment for a little longer. I'm so thirsty. I'm not in a relationship, so I'm both ways thirsty. Don't even judge me. Don't judge me, and I won't judge you. Don't judge me, and I won't. Okay, I'm done. Where was I? So I live in the South Coast here in Margate, which is about an hour and a half from Durban. Some of my hobbies include now TikTok, since I'm TikTok addicted, giving some help. So you back, I'm a savage. Yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet. Yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty. Hey. Yeah. Hacking, stupid, what was happening? Whoa. Yeah. What was happening? Whoa. I'm a savage. Yeah. TikTok dancing, I enjoy rap music, I'm all for feminists, so I usually like your pop, your hip-hop, your R&B, I love that vibe, Megan Thee Stallion, Killing the Game, love it to death, Nicki Minaj, The Queen,
I am the queen. You know,
Drake, I love all that kind of music. I want to do some reviews, so you let me know, if you guys want me to do a review on Megan Thee Stallion's brand new EP, Sugar. Like, comment, let me know. If I can get 10 likes on this video, that's very little, but I'll be aiming low. Small goals, you know, small goals. Then I will do a reaction on that album. What else was I gonna tell you? That's kind of my hobbies. I am a reservations manager. I work at a hotel. I do reservations and marketing. I enjoy my job a lot. There are some challenges to it, but I work with an amazing team and I'm very fortunate and I'm a very lucky person. I live with my mom and my family and they're crazy and I'm sure you guys are going to get to meet them and they're really crazy.
A few moments later.
Oh my god, Lynette, why are you screaming? Have this journey where you start with me from day one and then kind of grow with me. My entire aim of starting all my socials was to become an influencer because I feel like my market that I belong to, my niche market, is not really well represented in the market and really no one cares for us. If you don't look like either Kendall Jenner or freaking Drake, then obviously you don't count in the market. And to be honest with you, I know none of us feel like that. People feel like, you know, we still want to dress up sexy, we still want to look cute, but I know I'm wearing my dad's shirt, it's a Jeep shirt. Name brand check. My friend's rich check. I'm just joking, it was like super cheap, it's a knockoff. But I want to be able to create a whole brand around being overweight and being okay with it. And losing weight because you want to be healthier, not because some TV program or some lady with some small ass thighs and big bums told you that you ain't fine. You fine, girl. You fine. But I want to be able to create a whole brand around that. So if you guys support that, if you're with that, and it's not only about being overweight, it's about being too, like really underweight. Just any kind of body dysmorphia situations. I also really want to speak about depth about mental health and how it's affected me growing up. I know you guys have tons of questions about me. I'm like a whole episode of Stranger Things. I'm like the guy that looks like he has teeth but doesn't. That's the entire reason of me creating this YouTube channel. I want to become an influencer and become a voice for people that didn't really have a voice. I want to create clothing. Create the whole shebang. Obviously starting somewhere slow and building a following. Just so that people who are but not represented gets represented. I really want to be your Indian Martin Luther King Jr. Except ain't nobody should come kill me because I can still to get like deleted off YouTube. So you let me know if I get 10 likes on this video and I get maybe 2 comments or 5 comments. I'll say 5 comments and 10 likes. Then I am going to do the reaction of Megan Thee Stallion and I will post it as soon as I get my 10 likes. Well, I don't know what else should I tell you. Really show you guys who I am. And if you guys like my videos, give it a like and subscribe. I'm not sure to spam you or anything like that. But if you stand for a cause where it doesn't matter what you look like or what size you are, you're still beautiful. I know everyone says that, but I actually mean it. I really stand for us. This channel is about just being the king or queen of your own kingdom. That's why I call this the Kyledom. So when a king and a queen rules their kingdom, they make their own decisions. They make mistakes. And I want you guys to have a first-hand preview of them. If I could maybe just show one person it's okay to be yourself, no matter who cares. And the goal is not that to do it for what people care. It's just to be like, you know, I watched this really cool Nicki Minaj video and she said that you just gotta do you. And you gotta make people know that you'll stick around. Whether they're here or not, you'll be here. And they just don't want to accept you. And if they don't, it's one of those things. So let me know. Tell me if you like it. Tell me if you like my message. Because I really struggled in my weight. I was on a diet. I actually am on a diet, boo. I ain't gonna have a cut to the clip.
I am on a diet, boo. I am no longer eating anybody's BS, their negative energy, and other bitches' problems.
But I was really on a, like a non-carb diet. That failed when we went into lockdown. So I want to get into like that. Some meal prepping, you know. Showing you how. For any more fun, or you just want to get to know me a little bit more, my Instagram and my TikToks linked in the bio. It's at official Kyledom. You can even see it up in the cover picture. Go check those out. But till next time, love you lots. And thank you for visiting the Kyledom. Mwah!
I have a certain skill set that a lot of people don't know about because my group broke up, but I was really supposed to be the original Beyonce, for those who don't know.
If I back it up, is it fast enough? When I throw it back, is it fast enough? If I speed it up, can you handle that? You ain't ready for this work now. Watch me throw it back, throw back.